Welcome back. This is The Sit Down, and I'm here with Matthias Schoenaerts, who stars in the new film, The Mustang. How you doing, the man? Good morning.
I'm super excited. Thanks for having me.
Thank you so much for coming on. I love your leather jacket. It's a good look,
man. It's a good one, huh?
It looks real good.
It's horse leather. No, I'm kidding.
Don't. That is a terrible place to start
interview. I'm kidding. All right, well, it's a joke.
We do have a clip from the film, so let's play it.
Please stay there. Please, come on. Come on, please. Come on, stay there, man! Just fucking listen to me! Do you hear me? I'm not gonna hurt you! You hear me? You hear me, you stupid animal!
It is such a hard but beautiful film. It's so incredible.
Thank you.
Congrats. I just want to read real quick. The LA Times calls it startling, surprising, must-see acting. And you yourself have said that you kind of found it timely and relevant. What is it about the project that drew you to it?
Well, I think, you know, it's always important to, you know, tell stories about people that are less fortunate than we are. And also the subject has been on the forefront of the media lately. For example, Jay-Z has been, you know, investing $50 million in the prison reform program. Jane Fonda has been working on this. It's been on a mission for 30, 40 years. So I think it's really important to, you know, stand up for people, you know, who are in the corner.
Mm-hmm. And what is the film show? What is the kind of the special aspect here to the program that your character's in?
Well, I think, first of all, it's a real program. Mm-hmm. So it's a rehabilitation program that consists of training wild horses. Mm-hmm. And through that nonverbal interaction, basically, what we've seen, that it's also important to mention that the rehabilitation program is one of the most successful in terms of the percentage of recidivism is almost non-existent. So that's pretty, you know, startling. Mm-hmm. And what we see happen with inmates is that they come to life again. You know, they reconnect with themselves, they reconnect with others through you know, the redevelopment of having attention for, you know, for something outside yourself. Instead of being completely absorbed by yourself and by your own desires and by your own needs, because, you know, prison is a survivalist universe. So, and how do you survive there? It's through violence, through domination. And this program completely inverses that dynamic and makes you, you know, develop your attention outwards again.
And to be able to connect with the horse.
Definitely.
You said about working with the horses at first that it was scary as hell.
It's pretty scary. I mean, it's a very unpredictable, insanely powerful animal. Mm-hmm. So when you're in the pen with a, you know, Mustang, wild Mustang, it's like being in the ring with 10 Mike Tysons, you know what I mean? So imagine 10 Mike Tysons, how scary that must be.
I mean, they're big.
So a Mustang, oh, that's the equivalent. So, and I was not a rider. I was not familiar with. So, of course, I did all the, you know, training to understand what the process was. But, yeah, once you're in there and you're surrendered to the animal, it's like, okay, give it a swing and hope you don't die in there.
And hope it does. But it does. I mean, obviously, in the film, things go the way that they go. But yourself, you grew kind of attached.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm going to use the word co-star, to your co-star.
Yes, I fell in love with my co-star for the first time in my life. Yeah.
What was that attachment like?
I don't know. It's, you know, it's such a, you know, charismatic, beautiful, tender animal at the same time. So you it's hard not to get attached.
Do you guys get to see each other's?
The funny thing is the director and the producer, they bought the horse, which
really,
yeah, they bought it. It's on a ranch in LA, and yeah.
So do you swing
yeah,
by?
Of course, I have to see it.
That was incredible. Do you have a moment? Do you remember kind of when you got over the fear and realized that you were actually making a real connection?
Well, actually, I was not. I had a certain element of fear, but it was not that I was completely paralyzed by the fear. Mm-hmm. But there definitely was a moment that I lost the fear completely. Yeah.
Yeah. And
there was one moment that was really scary. There's a scene when we end up, there's the storm, the big storm, mm-hmm. and we end up in the kitchen. And we're in there, I think, with 15, you know, animals, and there's like, you know, the flickering lights. There's all metal objects everywhere. That's a day I was not really comfortable with the situation, because if one horse, you know, acts funny or acts jumpy, then that, you know, that's apocalypse right there.
You can actually get into a little bit of a panic. We also just a great cast in general, though. Let's talk about Jason Mitchell from The Chi. Just what an incredible actor. I feel like he does so well in this movie. And you guys sparked a friendship?
Definitely. Yeah, sometimes you have that. You run into people and it just happens, you know. You have a connection and instantly you stay connected and then you develop a friendship that all of a sudden, even though we hardly know each other. Mm-hmm. I've met him a year and a half ago, but we feel like the friendship is super cool. And he's an amazing actor, you know. He's so present and so, so rich in every performance. Brings texture, brings life, brings soul, brings passion, brings humanity. That's the qualities you look for in an actor. So.
Absolutely. Lindsay, you've also been very vocal about the want for equality, more equality in Hollywood. And this film is directed by
equality everywhere, basically, not only in Hollywood, just as a philosophy in general.
Yeah. And so what is it? What is it that draws you? What would you like to see more of? I know this film was directed by a woman. Two of the three people that works on the script were women.
I like to, for our thinking process to be less polar. Let's be masculine and feminine. Let's think about individual minds with inspiration and creativity and a talent, and let's not get stuck in like a woman and a man. I think it's way too poor of a polarity
of a binary.
Absolutely. I think it's
I want to play a game, though, talking about all the incredible actors that you've acted with. All right, we did some digging, and many of your co-stars have gone on to win an Oscar, or have won Oscars, all right? You've worked with a lot of Oscar winners.
True, yeah.
You worked with Marion Cotillard and Rustin Bone, right? Kate Winslet in Little Chaos, Alicia Vikander in The Danish Girl, Jennifer Lawrence in Red Sparrow, Jane Fonda in Our Souls at Night, and we saved the best for last year, because this one's not out yet. But you work with Meryl Streep in your next
movie. No, actually, she's in the same movie, but I didn't get to work with her.
You didn't get to work with her, but same movie.
Yeah, because Meryl Streep, she's
really...
That's Meryl Streep.
Meryl, calm. Yeah. Calm, absolutely. But so here's the game. I'm going to ask a question, and you'll choose one of the people that you've had the chance to work with that kind of answers the question best, okay?
Okay.
Okay?
Okay. Let's give it a swing.
Who would you most likely call... Who would most likely call you out on your bullshit? Who's going to shoot straight with you?
You mean female co-star?
Yeah, out of the names that I just read.
Jane Fonda.
Okay, most likely. Who would you allow? You don't tweet, but if you were to allow somebody to tweet on your behalf, who would it be?
On my behalf?
Yeah.
Marion Cotillard.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Because is it the funniness? Is it
funniness? But she's also very socially and politically engaged.
And you like that.
I kind of like that. Yeah.
Absolutely. All right. Who would you call? You know, you're in one of those situations where you only get one phone call. You're in trouble. Who do you call?
I have to. Everybody needs to be in there. Kate Winslet.
Okay. Who would you? I know you dress yourself.
Yeah.
I know you got. And again, leather jacket.
Today I'm lucky that I have a nice combination. Sometimes I look like a guy from Skid Row. But
I gotta say,
I'm looking at it, I'm like, hey, this is all right.
Yeah, it works. The blue,
I
black,
this,
the yellow, it's very nice. Yeah. But who would you let dress you for the Oscars?
Jane Fonda.
Jane Fonda's the one. All right, I'm gonna do one last one. Karaoke, duet. Who are you going with?
Who am I going with? With somebody that can sing, because I'm the worst singer in the world.
Yeah.
I sing like a squealing cat. So I need a real singer in there. I don't know. Who could sing from all the ones that you named?
Do you think, does Jennifer Lawrence know?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Jennifer was in there. She can sing, and she can save the performance.
She can save it.
I'm going to ruin it for sure.
What about a backup dancer? Could you be a little bit of a backup dancer?
Definitely Jason. He's definitely going to swing it.
All right. I absolutely love it. Thank you so much, man, for coming in, and congrats so much. The Mustang, it's in theaters now. It's a fantastic film. Go check it out.